Hi, welcome to the glass plate. In today's exercise, we're going to take a look at what happens on very hot and sunny days in the tropics or the subtropics. In particular, we're going to look at the sun radiating in on an asphalt road. So this is the black asphalt, sunlight coming in, and the sun, the solar flux, phi double dash sub s, which is roughly on a very clear day, 1,000 watt per meter square. What we would like to know is what happens to this asphalt. Recent reports during a heat wave in India predicted or mentioned that the asphalt was melting. And I would like to know the temperature of the road. Is it high? We know it's high from practice, you can burn your hands on it, but what would it be if we start estimating this? We do know that the surrounding, the air, on those very hot days has a temperature of about something like 40 C. If we try to analyze this, what we need to do is balance the heat. Solar light coming in, temperature difference probably arising between the hot road and the air, so heat going out. So if I make a simple balance, as usual, d dt equals in minus out plus the production, I can simplify this. I'm going to look at steady state. This is a zero. There is no internal production in a road of heat, so this is a zero. Incoming is a solar flux, phi double s, and we know the value. Out, okay, there is a temperature difference, so something like h times driving delta t between these two, the delta t, will evolve. And I can compute delta t once I know h. So I need to find the H value, so rephrase, what we prefer to do, we need to find the Nusselt number. Now, this type of flow from hot air below to colder air on top is governed by what we call free or natural convection. If we look up the H coefficient, or better, we look up the Nusselt number for this, we get an expression that reads something like Nusselt equals a constant dimension is 0.50 times what they call the Rayleigh number to the power 1/3. Now obviously that doesn't help if you don't know what the Rayleigh number is, but the Rayleigh number itself is given by gravity over kinematic viscosity over thermal diffusion coefficient, and for a gas, 1 over T average comes in, and then a length scale to the power 3. The length scale, for instance, the width of the road. In these terms, we have all constants. But unfortunately, something else slips in. This Rayleigh number, and thus this Nusselt, is in itself also a function of the driving temperature difference. This is multiplied by delta T, the unknown temperature. Okay, let's go through what we have. We do know what the solar flux coming in is, 1,000 watt per square meter. We have an expression for H via Nusselt, and we should remember, let me write it explicitly down, that H equals Nusselt times the lambda over the length scale, which I called L in this case. That is good news, because inversely proportional to L, and if you look at Nusselt, proportional to the 1/3 power of L to the third, which is a very difficult way of saying that it's proportional to L. So the L drops out here. And that's nice because I don't know in advance the width or the length of the road that I should take, but it doesn't matter. That is due to turbulence that starts above here and is beyond what we need to discuss here. Having this relation for the Nusselt number and thus for H, I can look at what do I know and what do I miss. As said, I do know the solar end flux. In the Nusselt number, I do know G, viscosity, kinematic viscosity of air. I need to look that up. 2, 10 to the minus 5 meters squared per second. A, thermal conductivity. I can look that up. Material property of air is also roughly 2, 10 to the minus 5 meters squared per second. Average temperature. Potential problem because I don't know which temperature to take. There's a hot and a less hot zone. But let's make a conservative estimate. This is already 40 centigrade. So let's put the average temperature something like 60, 70 degrees Celsius. And I need to evaluate this obviously in Kelvin, in the real SI unit. So let me equate that to something like 340 Kelvin plus or minus 10. This delta T is unknown, because that's what I tried to back out. If I now group this all together and I take delta T and another delta T that arises here to a 1/3 power, I have on the one side all the delta T's, I'm going to write them here, they are to 1 plus a third is 4/3 power, and that's going to be equal to the solar flux coming in, and then I need to divide by H except for the delta T part. Okay, if I do that, in H there is a lambda, the L scale drops out, so I need to divide by lambda, I need to divide by the Nusselt number, that is 0.15, I need to divide by this except for the L, and that goes upside down, so that is nu A T averaged over G, and this is still to the power 1/3. Now this actually is not so difficult. I have here my unknown to a power, and I have here only knowns that I estimated. Out of this I can easily compute delta T being everything here, so I don't copy it, but everything here to the power 3/4. And if you put in numbers, you're going to find that the delta T, let me look at my piece of paper, is a staggering 126 Kelvin, and thus the temperature of the road is 40 degrees Celsius plus this, according to our computation, is something like 170 centigrade. Sure, with this high temperature, the asphalt will melt and you cannot walk on it. Now, this is obviously exaggerated. It will not get that hot because once it reaches higher temperatures, also radiation back from the asphalt is important. And that is another mechanism of heat transfer out of the asphalt, thus reducing this temperature. Moreover, you will lose some of the heat also to the ground where it's sitting on. But the bottom line of our calculation is that it's no surprise that asphalt is melting.